Hello, America. This is John Strand, the Truth Maverick for Totally LA, a new right network, reporting live in Los Angeles, California at the Beverly Hills Freedom Rally every Saturday at 3 p.m. in defense of freedom. Joining me today is my friend Richard. Say hello.
Hi, how are you doing?
Amazing. Richard, you are of Chinese descent?
Yes, I am.
Okay. But you weren't born in China. You had an interesting journey through several parts of the world, and you have an interesting perspective. Tell us a little bit about yourself, why you're here, and why this movement is so important to you.
Well, I was born in Venezuela, in Maracaibo. So it was a prosper country.
It was wealthy at that time.
It was wealthy, yeah. Most of the Asian and American and European went to Venezuela because of the opportunity. But then when socialism came in, that's when everybody started moving out.
Yeah, so. Socialism kind of ruins things, doesn't it?
It does. It does. I mean, it was one of the richest countries in South America. Now it's one of the poorest countries in the world, almost.
So you grew up and spent most of your time in Hong Kong, is that correct?
I did. And it was under the British rule, and we have freedoms and freedom of speech and freedom to express your expression. Now the Communist Party is taking that away, and it's just terrible. No? And plus they have a 50 year agreement with the British that they're not going to change anything, but it seems like they just breached that contract. So.
Yeah, the CCP, or in other words, the Communist Chinese Party, which is the government group that's in power of that country, seems to have a habit of going back on their word, right?
Yes, for sure, yes.
So Richard, I have a question for you. This is something that really bothers me, speaking of what's true and what's false. I have insisted, as has the President, Trump, on calling the virus the China virus because it came from China, which I would say is very relevant and important to be aware of.
It is.
So as a Chinese person, do you take offense or think that it's inappropriate to call it the China virus?
No, I don't see the offensive because that's the origin of the virus.
Right, just like a famous virus that killed a lot of people at the turn of the previous century was called the Spanish flu because, at least I believe in their minds at the time, they assumed it was coming from Spain.
Yeah.
But regardless, tell us your perspective on this obsession with offending people with words, and what they're really doing is trying to change the meaning of words and confuse people about what's real and what's not.
Well, the problem is the liberal is trying to use the race card, and I think I truly believe that the Communist Party does have an influence in Hollywood and trying to spread their propaganda through this country so we can see them as a good people, but they're not really a good party. I mean, I'm not against the Chinese people in China. It's just the party that they need to go on.
Yeah, I think generally it's important to make the distinction that, you know, people are never the enemy, lies are the enemy. So when a powerful government like the CCP is operating on the basis of lies, which you just explained that they do quite often and quite consistently, that's a problem, and those lies are the enemy. But people are not the enemy, and we want to separate that.
That is true, and I'm truly sure most of the people in China are wanting to speak their mind, but they just worry that they may get arrested or put away if you speak against the CCP.
Put away, you can get disappeared. You can literally be killed.
Disappear, organ harvest, or whatever, you know.
All kinds of crazy stuff. Okay, so tell us your perspective for people who might be watching that might not realize the gravity, the severity of what you just explained, because that's in China, it's literally on the other side of the world, most people have never seen it or whatever. But we are seeing that happen in America. I mean, right here in Hollywood, in Los Angeles, California, I've been unable to put this hat on until recently because I just said, screw it, I'm over it now. They can come after me and I don't care. But people feel like they can't wear a red hat or speak their political opinions because they will be persecuted, they will be ostracized, they will be punished, they will be attacked, abused, hated, fired. Just their lives will be wrecked. And this is in America, where we're supposed to defend the freedom of all thought and all people. Tell the audience how you see what's been going on in China for a long time is creeping into America right in front of us.
Well, right now, the Communist Party is really trying to spread their ideology and influence throughout the world because that's their goal now, is to be the world dominant with their ideology. So right now, our freedom is being threatened by the Communist Party. And if we can't do anything about it, we may just give up and surrender. But I'm sure we're not going to let that happen, man.
No, these people are not surrendering, and we don't plan to anytime soon.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Richard, thank you so much for joining us at the Beverly Hills Freedom Rally. You guys, there's nothing more important than participating in your government because you are the government, so you need to vote. Please vote today if you can. Don't vote any later than November 3rd because that's the last day to do it. Vote for your values. Vote for freedom. You know the president that fights for freedom, so we love him. 4 more years. God bless America. We'll see you next time.
Do you have social media you want to put up?
I'm not a social guy, so...